Dear students, now we will be discussing about various specific teaching strategies. So in this regard, the first point is we will discuss various main strategies to be followed by the teachers having visually impaired learners. So first point will be more verbal. So verbal description will help the child interpret what is going on in the classroom. For example, use names when calling on children. Second, provide precise verbal description in place of vague statements and or motions when modeling on actions. In this regard, one example is fold the paper lengthwise. So we have to give the instruction in that way instead of fold the paper like this. Verbalize what is writing on the board or on overhead. Spell out words when appropriate. When referring to the objects, think about attributes other than color, such as shape, weight, texture, size, and location. Use normal language such as look and see. Help the child learn the workings of the classroom. Blind children in the early grades, like all children, have much to learn about classroom routine. Further specific teaching strategies. Help the child learn the workings of the classroom. Children with blindness in the early grades, like all children, have much to learn about classroom routine. It may need to teach the child to focus on the teacher, to respond quickly to instructions, how to respond, for example, raising the hand, answering aloud, answering in unison, and many such type of activities. Next, when and where to move in the classroom. Next is how to determine what others in the room are doing. Next is organize the child's desk area and materials storage area for maximum independence. Provide hands-on opportunities. These will make experiences more meaningful for the blind child. Adapt materials or parts of the lesson when necessary. Offer information instead of help. Instead of getting an object for the child, for example, give the child a chance to find it by describing its size, shape, and location. Then give the child enough time to explore and correct mistakes before teacher give more prompts. Understand and respect the skills of blindness. Learn the general sequence of the skills. Provide opportunities in the class for the child is working toward mastery. Further on special teaching strategies, now coming to the braille reading and writing is very much equivalent of print reading and writing. This is one of the most important strategies. Information can be reliably perceived through the sense of touch. The blind child should be moving about more and more independently as time goes on using orientation and mobility skills. The child will learn to use sound, memory, mental mapping, and various spatial tools, and will learn to ask for information when needed. Now, coming to the classroom management. So in this regard, the first point is lighting. So lighting should be adequate, whether it may be natural and artificial lighting. Good natural light is comfortable. More lighting is required in some cases. For example, retinitis pigmentosa. Dim or appropriate light is required in some cases. For example, albinism. The light should come behind and to one side of the person. The next factor is seating arrangement. The children can be placed in the middle or the front row. Not all low vision children prefer the front row. Children with tunnel vision will be comfortable when they sit a little back and on the sides, depending on their dominant eye. The children can sit where light comes more, for example, near the window or door to use light. The next factor is blackboard, or nowadays we are using some whiteboards also. The blackboards should be cleaned regularly. Writing should be clear, large and uncluttered. White or yellow chalks provide the best contrast. Coming to the next factor, that is writing. Writing can be tiring activity. Short breaks during writing activities reduce fatigue. Felt pens or nylon or metal tip pen provides good contrast. The children can be allowed to use black ink to get good contrast. Coming to the next factor, that is reading. Low vision services is more than deciding the child's reading medium, print or braille. Some children may read normal print textbook. Some can read large print. Some low vision children can read only braille, but they can use vision for other purposes. Some can read large print, but they are not able to write. Some children can write, but not for longer hours. Those children can be allowed to use scribe for their examinations. The next and another important factor is time modifications. So low vision children will often experience fatigue due to shorter working distance. The next point is postural problems. Due to severe postural problems also, sometimes they feel fatigue. The need to use a variety of low vision aids also made them fatigue. So other factors include all the furnitures should have blunt ends. The electrical switchboard panels should have easy accessibility. So another factor is use of assistive device, or other terminology we can use is assistive technology. For visually impaired individuals or children with visual impairment, technology has removed many barriers to education and employment. Learners with visual impairments can complete various tasks. In this regard, they can finish homework, can do research, take various tests and read various books along with their sighted classmates. So that's all in this particular video. Thank you very much.